I do two different things. So first, our group designs algorithms to look at brain MRI images and try to understand differences in anatomy in the brain between different groups of patients and healthy subjects. So we design these algorithms, and then we also apply them to different patient populations. Because we are in a hospital, the data that we get is patient data. A lot of our analyses are statistical analyses, which means that we're not looking at one particular patient, but we're looking at what a group of patients do. But we're also working with doctors to translate these things from the research to the clinic. So to write algorithms that then will look at individual patients and say, well, this patient has this part of their brain that's a little bit different, and this is something of concern, and maybe you should be looking more carefully at what happens here. For example, we recently did this study where we looked at premature newborns' brains, and we looked at this small little structure inside their brain called the putamen. We looked in very fine detail at the surface of the putamen, and we found that there is an area in the putamen that's different in premature newborns compared to full-term newborns. And this is the same part of the brain that's actually different in children with ADHD. One big advantage, actually, of our approach is that we're using MRI, which is now a very widespread way to image the brain. And it's also perfectly safe, which is a very big advantage compared to other ways to image the brain, for example. And so what we get is we get these really nice images, very clear images of the brain. And then with our algorithm, we can actually go and much more carefully quantify all the differences that there are in a particular patient's brain, for example, compared to how a child developing normally. So there's two advantages, I guess. The safety one, and then secondly, that we can go much more carefully and quantify much more carefully exactly what is happening in these children's brains.